Hey guys, welcome to the exciting tutorial of Creatnprocess, and in today's video we designed this logo. In this logo we have three arrows pointing in three different directions, and the shape formed by these arrows is looking like a 3D cube. And there's got a nice color shades here, and we need to notice one thing here is that the angle between the two arrows is constant. So if we consider to complete one circle, it's 360 degrees. So it's divided into three pieces, so it's going to be 120 degree each. We'll understand that further. Now, to start with our design, we'll first design these arrows, and secondly, we'll create that 3D cube inside. So we'll select the line segment tool and left click your mouse button. You've got a palette. Now keep the length 150 points and angle 90 degree and click OK. So you get a straight line. Now keep the stroke to 23 points, and now place it somewhere empty. Now duplicate this twice, Control C, Control F, and F. Now select the top one, go to transform and change the angle to 45 degree. Select the other one, go to transform and select it to change it to -45. Now the reason why we are doing is that we need this sharp point, which is formed by these two pieces, which is 90 degree each if we calculate. And if we consider it from this center line, it is going to be 45 by 45. So we have done that. Now we'll place this properly, zoom it in and go and place it there where it overlaps the points. So you need to see that, yeah, it's overlapping. Now bring the other piece also and place it there properly such that the three points are overlapping each other. You need to see that. Now after that, select the two pieces and go to stroke, and here the third option in the cap projecting, click it there, and you will see that you got a nice pointed edge here. Now the next thing is select everything, go to object and expand it to form into object form. Now go to pathfinder and just combine it to form a single piece. Now the next thing is we need this nice cut here, so we'll do some steps here. We'll just duplicate this, Control C and Control F for twice duplication to paste in the front, and now go to transform and keep the angle 120 degree. The reason why we are doing this because we know that the angle between each of these arrows is equal, so each, and it is dividing the whole circle into three pieces, so each angle is going to be 120 degrees. So that's what we are doing. Now select other piece and go to transform and write -120. That will bring the other piece. Now place it properly, and to place that properly we'll do one thing here. We'll use the ruler tool. Now select this object, go to ruler and bring out the line and place it there. Select this, we need the center point here, so with the ruler key just bring it and place it there. Now select these and bring it properly and place it properly in such a way that the points are overlapping each other, so just bring it there and place it there. Zoom it in and make sure it's overlaps, so you have to do it properly. Now bring the other piece, bring it there, just zoom it in, and so once you have kept all the PM points overlapping each other, you can now see that it has formed a nice shape here. The reason why we're doing is we need this cutting and intersection points here, so that we can get these parallel lines. So we'll do that. Now with the line segment tool, we'll draw out a straight line segment from this point with a shift click, drag it out and fill it with some certain color. The same way from here also, drag it out and fill it with some certain color, some thickness. Now you can delete these pieces because we don't need this now. We might need the ruler, so we'll just keep the rulers here. We need that point. Now with these line segments we are going to cut the edge. Now select the stroke, go to Object, Path, and Divide Object below. In the same way, select these other piece, go to Object, Path, and Divide Object below. This will delete the other pieces, and we can get the nice arrow here. We can do the same steps here. Duplicate this, Control C, FF, and top one, go to Transform, Angle 120. Again, select the other one, keep it minus 120. Now place it the same way we have done it before, so just select and make sure they are intersecting with each other. So just place it there properly, zoom it in, now select it, shift, move it upward, and place it there. The same way, select the other piece, bring it down, place the point perfectly with the grid, and select and just move it up until it touches each other. Now, once you've done that, we don't need the grid now, you can delete that. Now select everything and go to Pathfinder and just combine it. We need some certain thickness here, you can see that here at the edges, and here we have very thin, so we can increase that by selecting everything and going to the stroke and just increase the stroke thickness. So keep it around 3 maybe, and go to Object, expand it to form the fill object, and now combine it so it form a nice single object here. Now the next thing is to create the cube inside, and to create that we will do certain steps here. So we'll use the line segment tool, and from here till here we'll connect these points and fill it with their certain stroke thickness. From here till here we'll just connect these internal points, these points from here till here. Now the next thing is we'll create this, we need this divisions. So we are doing that using our line segment tool from the center here, just with the shift press drag it out and just place it there and give this thickness certain thickness. From the here also just drag it out and place it there properly so that it touches that line segment. Now with the direct selection tool we need to do certain adjustment. We don't need our points to be placed in the center, we need to be placed at the edge, so just select it and bring it out and place it beside the edge. So in the same way, select these pieces and bring it out and place it at the edge. Zoom it in and work out properly because it should touch the edges. In the same way, just see whether it's working or not, and it should be on the. Do the same thing from here, just make sure they touches each other. Now select the two line segments, the two short ones, group it, control group it. Now duplicate this twice, control C, control F, paste in the front. Now go to transform and keep the angle 120. Now place this here so that it touches these points. In the same way, we'll select the other piece, go to transform and keep the angle minus 120 and bring this here and make sure it touches these points, and we can see that it's going nice. Just zoom it in and with the die selection tool just do certain adjustments so that there's no problem further. So make sure it's going along the line, zoom it in and just make sure it touches the edges so that when it cuts from the end points, not from the center. Here we need some, we have left some space, so we need to just push it out and just make sure they overlap each other like this. Yeah, okay, nice. Now once you have done that, we'll ungroup those pieces so that we can select individually, like ungroup it, ungroup this, and ungroup this. Now select these pieces, this corner, all the pieces here at this space, go to object, path, and join it. Select these, go to object, path, and join it. Select these, go to object, path, and join it. The reason why we are doing this is we need this as one group, these strokes as one group, and this stroke as one group, so that we can cut the so that we can divide the object below properly. So after this we'll draw a nice rectangle from here, which is going through. Just place it there properly. Now fill this with some certain color, maybe white, and arrange it to back, control, and then extend it to backward. Now select this piece and this black portion and just divide it, and now ungroup it. Delete this unwanted piece. Now we are left with the internal piece only. So now select this stroke, go to object, path, and divide object below. In the same way, select these pieces, go to object, path, and divide object below. These pieces, go to object, path, divide object below. And in this way, we have separated all the pieces. You can see that. That step has made our work much, much easier. Now, fill this with this color. And here we have already prepared our color palettes. We have already chosen our color where we want to be, which color we want to fill at this position. So we have already prepared the color palette and the text also. So we'll use that color palette now. Now select the piece with the selection tool, and with the eye picker, just select the color. Select the piece, selection tool, eye picker, selection tool, eye picker. V for selection tool, I for eye picker. So do it for all the rest. Selection tool, eye picker, V, and I. For selection, select the V key with the I, select the I color. Selection tool, eye picker. So it has gone nice. And we can see that after filling the color, it has formed that nice 3D effect here. Now the only thing is to rotate it to an angle. So we'll rotate that nicely and place it properly. We can scale it down a little bit. And here we go. Now the last thing we are left with is our text. So with the text, we'll write out our text, Yawl, Yawl. That's our logo name. Now the attributes which you have done to create this is, we have gone to the character and we have keep this value, the distance between each alphabet. We have put around 4500, and we have, you can even use this to capitalize all your text. So we have done that. And after that, what we need here is we need to scale it down a little bit. So we'll go to text and just scale it down so that we can get a nice size of it. We can go to object now, expand it to convert this into fill object form. Now you can manually scale it down and place it there where you want to place. And overall, we have completed the text as well as the logo. So this is how we can create these handsome kinds of logo. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates from designing, you can press the subscribe button. Thank you.